Okay. Hey, what is going on, everyone? Daniel Tapia here one more time. And in this video, we're going to cover how do I get rid of carb cravings? Yeah. So if you're in our Iron Beauty fitness program, you have some of these questions. And if you're following the nutrition plan that we have provided you, some of these things will be addressed already. But I know that there's some other questions you might have. So that's what this video is about, is to address those particular questions and help you understand where carb cravings actually come from and some things that can allow you to get rid of it. Now, I'm not going to get into a whole bunch of like super scientific stuff. I'm just going to kind of give you some principles that might be able to address what you're feeling right now. And if you get those aha moments, that would be awesome, because that's ultimately what I want to do. So let's get right into it. Yeah. Why do you get cravings? I see a lot of people always saying like, oh, I can't stop eating candy. I can't stop eating carbs. I can't, like, I have to eat chocolate every day. I know one of my clients, Dottie, for a very long time, she's like, I have to have chocolate every single day. And I just asked her, hey, how about we try to, you know, maybe, you know, stop eating chocolate for maybe a week. So she stopped eating chocolate for about 3 or 4 days. She stopped eating chocolate for about 3 or 4 days. And it was so weird that, like, we checked her weight, because she was like, yeah, I'm stopping eating chocolate, so my calories have gone down, so I should lose weight, right? Well, understand this. Dottie has hypothyroidism, which basically means her thyroid is like not working. And the thyroid is the hugest, one of the most important parts of weight loss, because it regulates weight loss. So her thyroid basically doesn't work, right? So she stops eating chocolate, so she eats less calories. So we check back in about 3 to 4 days. In 3 to 4 days, she had gained like 2 pounds. And I'm like, yo, forget that. Just eat some chocolate. So she eats chocolate, and those 3 or 4 pounds came off like within the weekend. So I'm like, ah, man, sometimes you gotta take care of business. Like, you cut out something else. Don't cut out the good stuff, right? But I'm going to talk to you a little bit about what actually causes some of the cravings. And hopefully this will give you a little better understanding of why you get cravings. So number one is stress. Stress causes a buildup of cortisol and a buildup of, it causes tension. And I'll cover it a little more in detail in the next following slides. But these are the four things that we're going to cover: stress, habitual problems, low nutrients, and you're dieting too hard. So to my right, the little picture you're seeing is hormones that actually control hunger. So if you see that on your right-hand side, these right here, the pancreas, the lower bowel, lower small bowel, fat cells, leptin is very, very important. So for fat loss, leptin is awesome. This is like the biggest one is this one right here. So if we can stimulate leptin, you would actually increase fat burning potential. And that's what our Iron Beauty Fitness program is for. We are here to stimulate leptin, to make leptin work better. Okay. Now, insulin-like peptides, they increase hunger, which some of these things would be like, if you don't fill up your stomach with like fiber and stuff, you're putting candy and all that stuff through your colon. This will be secreted, which means it will make you be hungry. Ghrelin is like, it's like the hunger hormone. They call it the hunger hormone, but it's like when your stomach is empty. So you fill it up with like fruits and vegetables and fiber and protein, and you turn that off. So you inhibit hunger. You increase this, you increase this right here, you increase this, and you increase this. So those are just hormones if you ever want to look at that. But let's get right into it. So let's look at some habitual problems. So normally, even if you're dieting, your habits cause a very, very, very big part of why you're actually hungry. So if you have a habit of waking up and drinking a cup of coffee, and you're doing our Iron Beauty Fitness program, you're going to be doing a very specific type of eating and training to tone up the arms, the legs, hips, and thighs while losing body fat, so you don't have to spend hours at the gym or counting calories. But if your habit is to wake up drinking coffee and you stop that, you've habitually trained yourself to wake up and drink coffee. So your mind is going to tell you, Well, your body's going to tell you that you have to drink coffee. And if you drink coffee and eat candy or cookies, I know my mom likes to drink coffee and eat cookies or something sweet with her coffee. That's just the Hispanic way of doing things. We want to wake up and we want to drink a cup of coffee and have some dulce or I'm not, no, no dulce, some sweet bread, right? Like that's a habit. That's a like cultural thing. So if you stop that, your body is going to, it's kind of like if you're doing crack cocaine. Okay. Like if you do crack cocaine, I've never done it. I'm just saying that because I know people that have done it. When you do it, your body is craving that feeling. Your body is craving it. Your mind doesn't need it, but your body is craving it. So it's the same thing with coffee and sweet bread. Like your body will crave it because it's been there so long that when you take it away, it doesn't know what to do besides try to get it back. So it's like parasitic. You know what I mean? So those are some habitual problems that you're going to deal with. Now understand that these are things that are habitual. So if you change it, you're not hungry. Okay. Understand that you can tell this to yourself. And this is how I tell myself. When I'm craving something, I'll just say, am I really hungry? Or is this something I've done in the past that has made me feel content? And then when I start to think of that, I'm like, okay, well, you know what? I really don't need a bag of chips. It's because I've trained myself that when things went bad, I ate a bag of chips. So are things bad enough that I need a bag of chips? And then I think, well, no, you know what? Actually, I don't need a bag of chips. I can be okay today. It's not actually hunger. It's just habit. And since it's habit, I can change it. So it's not my hunger. So I'm not hungry. And so when you tell yourself those things, you start questioning if it's habit or hunger, then you can actually break that pattern. That's how you break a pattern, is interrupt it. Okay. Or maybe you eat a snack after dinner every day and you feel hungry because you're trained that way, right? Kind of like if you're driving down the street. Have you ever driven down the street? Like play with me real quick in this scenario. Let's say I'm going to Walmart, right? I go to Walmart every 2 to 3 days to get some groceries, right? So I drive the same road. I drive down the same road. I hit the same lights and all that stuff. And for some reason, I'm driving one day and I get to Walmart and I'm like, holy smokes, did I stop? Did I run a red light? I don't remember driving here. Have you ever felt like that? Like when you're driving somewhere you've always driven and you don't know, like if you don't know how you got there, you're like, man, I don't remember driving. I know tons of people that have that, but it's because your brain has done it enough times that it puts into the subconscious. Okay. And when it's into the subconscious, you don't think about it no more. So it's unconscious competence. So you don't have to think about it. It's like your brain finds ways to do less work. It never wants to do more work because when you put more work on the brain, it burns more calories. Yeah, you. That's what happens when you do these type of eating programs, when you change a eating habit, it's because your habits are telling you, we've done this a certain way all the time. It's subconscious. Now you're retraining your brain to fight against that. So understand that these are, you're fighting habits. Okay. So understand that you're not hungry. It's just something that you've done in the past that we're breaking now. We're breaking patterns. Okay. So habitual problems will get you. Stress. Okay. How to combat stress. Now our exercises in the Iron Beauty Fitness program are specifically meant to maximize the feel good hormones, dopamine and endorphins. Okay. So have you ever heard, oh, my endorphins are rushing, or have you ever worked out so hard and you take a shower and you just like, I feel good. Like you have that big breath, like, yep, that's good. That kind of thing is through dopamine and endorphins. So our exercise program in the Iron Beauty Fitness program are specialized to maximize that feel-good hormone, the dopamine and the endorphins. So when you do our exercises, it's meant to maximize those feel-good hormones, which, you know what? It's kind of crazy because those type of exercises, studies have shown that those type of exercises that we put in our Iron Beauty Fitness program have been scientifically matched. They can say that they match the same effects that you get when you do drugs or have sex. So that feel good hormone that you get from that, and there's oxytocin as well, but that's more for women. You know, when a woman has a baby, and if they don't have any oxytocin, right, it's a hormone, and they don't feel connection with the baby, that's why women have the postpartum depression, is because they don't have that oxytocin production. So now you know why women sometimes go through that postpartum depression, is because that hormone is not there. And our exercises are not meant to maximize oxytocin, but dopamine, we can definitely increase dopamine and endorphins through exercise. And stress comes from norepinephrine, which is a hormone that causes internal stress, and cortisol. Okay. So another thing you can do is meditation or pray. I like to stretch. I personally like to stretch and do some type of yoga in the morning, or meditate and pray in the morning. Like any and all of those things work. Okay. Do not turn on the news. I know it's crazy, but think of it this way. They're a business. They must turn a profit. They've known for years that shocking and breaking news make the human body's norepinephrine, which is like the fight or flight. Like when someone, like, have you ever like expected to get in a fight? Or even if you haven't, like you saw a fight and you just, for some reason, you feel like tension in your body. You feel like pressure. That's where norepinephrine comes in. Like it's that fight or flight. Like if you're going to get chased by a dog, kind of like that, like it causes that internal stress and cortisol spike, which makes internal tension, right? So just so happens the best news is the bad news, because it's what gets most internal tension. And people have tested this over and over and over, and the tension becomes addicting. So I know if it's a tough pill to swallow, but it is what it is. So stop watching the news. It's very, very bad for you. In fact, they did a study at MIT. Okay, they did a study at MIT, and they showed that your negative 86% of our thoughts are negative thoughts every single day. So now, try to lose weight again, it's like 86% chance of you losing. But here's the good thing: if you listen to enough good things, you meditate enough 17 times. If you listen to something good 17 times, you have to use it 17 times to combat something bad. So if they say you can't do something, you have to listen to someone saying you can 17 times before you get rid of that one can't. Okay, so I know it's a huge, huge thing to overcome, but let me just tell you, relieving stress is amazing. So you don't want to have stress. Go through these things. Understand what I'm saying. Have fun. Let's do this. Yeah. And low nutrients. Okay. So what nutrients? Remember, leptin is the most powerful appetite suppressing hormone. It's made in the fat cells, discovered in 1994. The more fat cells we have, the more leptin produces. Okay. So we're not going to talk too much about leptin. We might talk about it later. But low vitamin B. Okay. Low vitamin B. That means it regulates hunger, helps with the thyroid function, and regulates metabolism. So vitamin B, thiamine, niacin, B12. So any B vitamins that you get actually help out with your hunger. Okay. So make sure you're staying up to date with your vitamins, your vitamin B, vitamin Z. C helps with addiction, appetite control, and craving. So vitamin C has become in recent studies, it's been very, very good. So you want to make sure you have good vitamin C. And it helps with, obviously it helps you combat oxidant stress, which basically means like cell stress, like stress on the cells and then on the cellular level of your body. So it actually helps you prevent you from getting sick, right? And that's why they say to get like vitamin C when you're feeling sick, or get like to drink like orange juice and all that stuff. It's because of that stuff, okay? And low vitamin D. So I personally take about 2,000 units IU. So it says 2,000 IU. That's units. And don't get scared of that number per day. Because if you only spend 20 minutes outside in the sun, you get about 20,000 units from the cell, which is amazing. But I understand some people don't get a chance to be in the sun for 20 minutes a day. So you can supplement it with a pill, okay? So you'll get some vitamin D supplements, or I would recommend vitamin D supplements. You can get them from Walmart, wherever. It doesn't really matter. But you also want to get magnesium, because magnesium helps out the absorption, and vitamin D and calcium. Okay. Vitamin D, calcium, and magnesium help absorption of each other. Okay. So, and then omega-3s. I know I put that in our in our Iron Beauty Fitness program. So I omega-3s, you can also get those. Make sure you have it should equate to 1 gram or 1,000 milligrams of DHA and EPA. Okay. So if I'm not mistaken, it should be 600 milligrams or 6.6 grams of DHA and 0.4 or 400 milligrams of EPA. All right. So number four is you're dieting too hard. So how do you know if you're okay on a diet? You're losing an average of 1 to 2 pounds per week. Some people will vary in relative weight because, for example, if you're 300 pounds, it's not uncommon to lose 5 pounds a week. Okay. So don't get too scared about that. Number two is you're starting to feel nauseous, like for no particular reason. Or number three, you're getting more emotional than usual. So those are some typical signs of you're dieting too hard. And if you're getting irritable and like pressy at people, you might be dieting too hard also. But remember, it could come back to habitual habits too. You might be getting angry because you're relapsing from cutting out sugar, or you're cutting out certain particular things in your diet that are causing internal stress with you. Okay. So understand that not all of this stuff, you're not always dieting too hard. Now, if you know that you're dieting too hard, is if you start to feel these things, you're starting to lose like 5 pounds in a week and you're 110 pounds. Okay. Or you're 120 pounds and you're losing 5 pounds a week. That is very, very bad. Okay. So with that being said, I know I went overboard in this video, but I truly appreciate you. And let's get into the next videos. I want you to watch these videos so that you can go out of this Iron Beauty Fitness program with fire. Like, you know that no matter what, no matter how, you are going to rip this program apart. This is going to be your best program. This is going to be the most intelligent program you've ever taken. This is going to be the most knowledge you've ever needed on nutrition and exercise. And it's the most comprehensive fitness program out there on the market. So I'm doing this for you because I want to ensure your success every single day. I want to make sure that you are set up for success. And you, even if it's too much, even if I feel like I'm pushing you with a water hose through your mouth, I want to make sure that even if I give you 1,000 words, 2 words stick. I'd rather you give you 1,000 words and 2 words stick than give you 1 word and no words stick. Okay. So I have to push for you, for you, for you. I want to see you succeed. I want to see you succeed. I want to see you succeed. I do. I truly do. So, I wish you all the success in this program. And if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to ask them. I know sometimes people have a hard time asking them because they don't want to seem stupid. They don't want to seem like they're asking the wrong questions and they should know these answers. But no, I am here for you. My duty, my obligation is to choose you over anything else. You are my duty, my obligation, and I'm here to protect you, not destroy you. So with that being said, I want you to go back and watch this video. I want you to get fired up because today is your day. You are great. You can do everything. You can be anything you want to be. You can have all the success in life that you've always wanted. Now it's your time. It's your duty. It's your duty, your obligation to fight for your family, to fight for everyone around you, to become successful, because success is no success unless you have a successor. Okay? You cannot be successful in your journey unless you have someone to share it with. So I want you to be successful so you can share it with the world. Share your story. Your mess is your message. And your test is your testimony. Okay? Understand that. Your test is your testimony. Your mess is your message. You have no success unless you have a successor. So share it. Become successful so you can share this with the world. It is your duty. It is my duty to you. So my duty is to become successful enough that I have successors, people that are going to go out there and fight this battle against healthy living and health and healthy mindsets. Okay. So with that being said, watch this video again. Go through it as many times as you need to, and keep fighting the good fight. Let's do this. Let's do this. We will see you in the next video.